Hello students, welcome to AJ Akshara Academy YouTube channel. In this session, I am going to discuss mechanical properties of fluids. In this, speed of efflux, Torricelli's law, venturi meter and heart attack. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Please share your valuable comments in the comment section. Okay, let us go to the today's session. Now, first one. Torricelli's law. The word efflux means fluid outflow. Torricelli discovered that the speed of efflux from an open tank is given by a formula identical to that of a freely falling body. So that is, now consider a tank containing a liquid of density rho with a small hole in its side at a height y1 from the bottom. See, here in this picture it is a tank containing a liquid of density rho with a small hole in its side at a height y1 from the bottom. See, here this is the height from the bottom, from small hole to bottom height, that is y1. From the equation of continuity, we have v1 a1 that is equals to a2 v2, or a1 v1 is equals to a2 v2. From this equation, it can be written as v2 is equals to a1 by a2 into v1. So, if the cross-sectional area of the tank A2 is much larger than that of the hole, then we may take the fluid to be approximately at rest or at the top. So, that is V2 is equals to 0. The condition is A2 is greater than A1. A2 is much larger than that of the hole. Now, applying Bernoulli's equation at points 1 and 2 and noting that at the hole, P1 is equals to PA, that is atmospheric pressure. Now, from the Bernoulli's principle, PA plus half rho V1 square plus rho GY1 is equals to P plus half rho V2 square plus rho GY2. Here Y1, Y2 are the heights. Taking y2 minus y1 is equal to h, we have v1 is equals to square root of 2gh plus 2 of p minus pa by rho. When p is greater than pa and 2gh may be ignored, the speed of efflux is determined by the container pressure. So, applying the condition, then the speed of efflux is determined by the container pressure. Such a situation occurs in rocket propulsion. On the other hand, if the tank is open to the atmosphere, then P is equals to PA and V1 is equals to 2GH. Here in this case, in the place of P, you can substitute PA, then it becomes here PA minus PA 0. So, the remaining equation is V1 is equals to, we are getting square root of 2GH. This is the speed of a freely falling body at any point of height h during its fall. This equation is known as Torricelli's law. So, this equation V1 is equals to square root of 2GH, or here in the place of Y2 minus Y1 substituting H. So, then the equation becomes V1 is equals to square root of 2GH plus 2 of P minus PA by rho. So, this equation is known as Torricelli's law. Now, we will discuss venturi meter. The venturi meter is a device to measure the flow speed of incompressible fluid. So it consists of a tube with a broad diameter and a small constriction at the middle. So this is the picture of venturimeter, and it consists of a tube with a broad diameter and a small constriction at the middle. Okay. A manometer is in the form of a U-tube is also attached to this. With one arm at the broad neck point of the tube and the other at the constriction. See, this is the manometer in the form of a U-tube is also attached to it with one arm at the broad neck point of the tube and the other at the constriction. The manometer contains a liquid of density rho. Here this manometer contains the liquid density, that is we are denoting as rho m, that is manometer density. The speed v1 of the liquid flowing through the tube at the broad neck area A is to be determined from the equation of continuity. Speed at the constriction becomes V2 is equals to A V1 by A. Then using Bernoulli's theorem, we get P1 plus half rho V1 square is equals to P2 plus half rho V2 square A by A whole square. So that P1 minus P2 is equals to half rho V1 square of A by A whole square minus 1. Now, this pressure difference causes the fluid in the U-tube connected the narrow neck to rise in comparison to other arm. So, the difference in heights h measures the pressure difference. So, that is P1 minus P2 is equals to rho gh is equals to half rho V1 square of A by A whole square minus 1. So that the speed of fluid at wide neck is V1 is equals to square root of 2 rho gh by rho of A by A whole square minus 1 whole to the power of minus 1 by 2. So from this equation we are getting this speed of fluid. Now I will discuss applications of venturimeter. First one, the carburetor of automobile has a venturi channel, that is nozzle, through which air flows with larger speed. The pressure is then lowered at the narrow neck and the petrol is sucked up in the chamber to provide the correct mixture of air to fuel necessary for the combustion. Filter pumps are aspirator, Bunsen burner, atomizer and sprayers used for perfumes or to spray insecticides work on the principle of this venturimeter. Now, blood flow and heart attack. Bernoulli's principle helps in explaining blood flow in artery. The artery may get constricted due to the accumulation of plague on its inner walls. So, in order to drive the blood through this constriction, a greater demand is placed on the activity of the heart. So, the speed of the flow of the blood in this region is raised, which lowers the pressure inside, and artery may collapse due to this external pressure. The heart exerts further pressure to open this artery and forces the blood through. As the blood rushes through the opening, the internal pressure once again drops due to the same reasons, leading to a repeat collapse. So this may result in heart attack. See this picture. Okay, next. Now I'll discuss MCQs. Venturimeter is used for measuring the flow rate of a liquid through a pipe is based on the Archimedes principle, Bernoulli's principle, law of flotation, Stokes theorem. So this venturimeter is used for measuring the flow rate of a liquid through a pipe is based on the Bernoulli's principle. Okay, next. Inchrometer is a device used to measure the flow speed of dash fluid, compressible fluid and volatile fluid and viscous fluid and incompressible fluid. So, inchrometer is a device used to measure the speed of incompressible fluid. Okay, next. Heart attack can be explained based on the which principle? Dash principle. First one, Archimedes principle. Second one, Bernoulli's principle. Third one, law of flotation. And fourth one, Stokes theorem. So, heart attack can be explained based on the Bernoulli's principle. Okay. Thanks for watching this video. Thank you.